That's why I usually go for the lowest hanging fruit. I just take my profit and I call it a day. That's it.
I spent the last 7 months forward testing and backtesting the 2022 ICT mentorship and its fair value gap. After watching more than 40 hours of Papa ICT and logging 180 trades, I think I find my model. So let's test it.
We start on the 15 minutes. We put the important levels such as the midnight open, the 8:30 open, and some levels such as yesterday's high and yesterday's low.
I'm also working on a video showing all of my 180 fair value gap trades. This will include all the screenshots and the tools I use to come up with this trading plan. You can subscribe to keep an eye on this video. I think this will help some ICT students come up with their own rules and plan.
Then we go quickly on the 5 minute. Let's now wait for the 9:30 open. Because of all the volatility, I prefer not to trade before that. And also I prefer to wait for 10 a.m. before putting an order. So you can see a fair value gap here that wasn't being tested again. That can happen sometimes. And we're getting close to yesterday's high. So let's keep an eye on that. So it came back, filled this fair value gap. Came back once again, fill this fair value gap. But you can see that this one and this one work pretty well. After taking yesterday's high, we saw a displacement, which is of 400. I need at least 600, so no trades. Came back, filled this fair value gap. But this is not a trade for me because I need first some liquidity to be grabbed, such as a stop hunt. And we had nothing here, so this is not a trade for me. What I would like to see is after taking yesterday's high, we see a start of going down. So we see a displacement going down, then we come back up and then we go down. This is what I would like to see. Here, you could take those fair value gap. You can see clearly that it's working pretty well, but this is not what I usually trade. Once again, I trust my model, I trust that it's making money on the long term because I have so much data. So there's a small fair value gap here. Let's see if we got enough displacement. Not yet, it's at 500 now. Okay, maybe now we have it. Yes, we do. So we have the liquidity taking out above yesterday's high. Why is there liquidity here? Because a lot of people who sold here yesterday put their stop losses here. So we came back, took them up, and then we started going down. And we left here a fair value gap. And there's also this low that was broken, this one and this one. And since I have all the rules met, I just put my order here, go for at least 250. Stop loss above the fair value gap. In this case, the stop loss is also above this high, so it gives another layer of protection. And then I like to go for 2.5 at least usually, because there's this low here that I could go for, which is there's a small fair value gap right there. And then there's this one here with the fair value gap here, and then a third one here. But I always go for the easiest one, which is above 2.5. So in this case, this would only be a 2, and this one is a 2.8. So I would go with this one just because it's above 2.5. And now let's see. I need the price to go up, fill my order, and then go back down. Okay, so I'm filled now. That's it. That's simple. So a nice 2.78. Let's now check if there's another trade coming in, because I'm still waiting for 11 a.m. I'm still allowed to take some trades. Okay, maybe there's something forming here. No, because after taking this low here, so there was a little bit of liquidity here. We saw displacement leaving this fair value gap right there, but I didn't get the 600 movement. So this is another trade for me. But you can see that it worked, and it's okay with me. I don't mind not taking trades. I just know that on the long run, what I'm doing is working. But this fair value gap, we came back to it and then went back up. Check what's happening after. It would have stopped me out. So that's why I usually go for the lowest hanging fruit. I just take my profit and I call it a day. That's it. And since we're past 11 a.m., no more trades for me. And I'm very satisfied with the results.